You know, when people are very loving, we say they have a large heart. But that's not what this passage is talking about. This passage is talking about multiple skill, multiple ability. It was indicative of a heart that has reached great boundaries of achievement. I pray for you today that the Holy Ghost himself will turn your life around. Will turn your life around. Mesa, itulombre, ishkaprindo si prelido dusa. You've lost some major things, but everything you lost, there shall be a restoration. A restoration. A restoration.
Getting stronger each day, living life with winning ways. Hope for the hurting, peace for the pain.
Fulfilling my purpose, I'll never be the same.
Raising champions each day, winning ways.
Pressing on cause I've got a break free.
Turn defeat into victory.
From darkness to light,
the emperor was right.
And I'm striving to grow every day.
Live my life in the ultimate way.
Reaching higher each day.
Learn to walk in his way. Raising champions each day. Winning way.
A life in progress is a journey full of milestones. Ticking the right boxes, reaching your aspirations with wisdom, excellence, knowledge, purpose, favor, skills, vision, winning, righteousness, and being daring.
God also wants us not to settle for just about anything. He wants your life to be 100% improved so that you do not settle for what others settle. You become a better person.
Join Pastor Matthew as he shares on these pillars and experience a 100% life improvement. Strategize to win. Define your pathway to success. Make your mark and maximize life. It's time for a 100% life improvement.
Hello there. Today you were given a suitcase packed with time, 24 hours. 1,440 minutes, 86,400 seconds. What are you going to do with it? What have you done with it? What act of service have you rendered? What deed of kindness have you given? Whom have you prayed for? Who have you shared the gospel with? Is someone going to eat today because of you? How are you improving the life of those around you? These are questions that should always motivate us. Well, let us go into the Word for today. I'll see you later.
Wherever you are in the journey of life, you can always make that turnaround, live to the maximum, and experience a 100% life improvement. It's time to make a mark. Get this series today, available in CD, DVD, and MP3. Call now, quoting the reference number on the screen, or visit kiccshop.org.uk. 100% life improvement. Make your life a masterpiece. And now for today's message.
Your life has got to improve 100%, but this can only be possible as you increase your capacity, as you increase your ability to receive what God has for you. Solomon could have just been like any other king before himself. In the ancient days, all the kings did was to just take care of state affairs, rule over the people, and don't do anything. But Solomon decided he was going to be a different man. He was going to increase his capacity and not be like his father or other kings who lived before him, who just would just wake up in the morning and rule over the people. Solomon became a man who stretched himself, expanded his mind, studied everything available to be studied. Solomon was not only a king, he was a horticulturist. He knew about every flower. He was a marine engineer. He knew about every ship. He was an animal biologist. He studied each animal in his time. Solomon was a creative artist. He wrote plays. The Songs of Solomon, which we read today as a as an inspired book was also a play of the role of Israel and the king who is God himself. Amen. When you read it, you see different people. He was also an artist who wrote songs. He wrote 1,005 songs. He wrote thousands of proverbs. Solomon was also a botanist. He studied the flowers. He studied the trees. He studied the things around him. He was a poet. He wrote beautiful poetry. He was a dramatic artist. Solomon was so gifted that he stretched himself. While his father was a king and a warrior, Solomon exceeded his father. And with all these things that Solomon was doing, this in chapter 1 Kings chapter 4, when you get home, you can read it. The Bible says in the days of Solomon, there was so much peace, there was no war at all. Not just because his name prophetically means the son of peace, but also because he was a man who was gifted in managing things. God wants you to stretch yourself and not just say, well, I don't have many gifts. Until you stretch yourself, you wouldn't find the abilities that are in you. And you've got to improve your life 100%. The Bible says in the passage which we just read, 1 Kings chapter 4, verse 29 to 34, that Solomon had largeness of heart. Largeness of heart. This was not a description of his natural heart. Neither was it a description of the state of his emotion. You know, when people are very loving, we say they have a large heart. But that's not what this passage is talking about. This passage is talking about multiple skill, multiple ability. It was indicative of a heart that has reached great boundaries of achievement, new levels for God. So the Bible, when it says largeness of heart, the New International Version puts it like this. Solomon had a breadth of understanding as measureless as the sand of the seashore. He had incredible understanding. I pray for you today that God will expand your mind, increase your understanding, and bless you on all sides in the name of Jesus. The reason many of us struggle is because we are underperforming. Not that we are not gifted, but we've never really pushed ourselves to perform to the level of our gifting. We are underperforming. We are firing below our capacity, and we are not stretching ourselves. We often look for comfort zones where nobody troubles us. In fact, some people, once they are in an atmosphere where everyone is putting pressure on them to become a different person, they move. They move. Not because anyone has said the wrong thing to them, but because the way people are putting pressure on them, they have to improve. And they are not ready for improvement. They just move out of the place. They move out of the place. We are not increasing our capacity, and therefore operating below how we could achieve, below what we could become. And you know, many times we try to now fill the gap with prayer, hoping that God will do what we ought to do. But you see, God will not replace you. He will have to wait for you to be whom you ought to be. There are things God cannot do for you no matter how long you pray. And there are things he will do which you cannot do. When Jesus came to the grave of Lazarus to raise him from the dead, Jesus refused to roll away the stone for them. He said, you want to see Lazarus? He's inside that grave. He's a dead man. There's no way you can raise him. But you can remove the stone. So, ladies and gentlemen, remove the stone if you want me to raise Lazarus for you. You see, before Jesus raised Lazarus, they had to move the stone. Also, if they didn't move the stone and if Jesus raised Lazarus, they wouldn't know the man is a living man anymore because they've not moved the stone. So many times there are things we want God to do which he will never do. God can't help you love your husband. You have to love him yourself. God can't help you love your wife. God can't help you get out of bed. If you like, you can sleep there for 24 hours. There are things no one else can do for you. So if your life is going to improve, you got to push yourself, stretch. Tell your neighbor to stretch. So a failure to increase capacity is an indication of our underachievement. And there are so many people who are not doing well with their life, who are not making impact, they are not maximizing. They are complaining about financial inadequacy, not because there is no money in the city, but because they have not changed their own method for looking for it. They are complaining of their being employed in some job they don't like. It is not because there are no other jobs, but because they have not chosen to re-engineer their life. And so they complain that nobody is giving them employment. Do you know right now in this city, there are jobs they can't find anyone to fill. While there are some other jobs which 1 million people are pursuing two jobs. Please tell your neighbor to stretch. So every time you want to improve 100%, somebody wants to settle for where they are. They don't think it's possible. So you've got to understand, we cannot settle for little performance, little results, little achievement, little vision, little ambition, and wonder why our life has remained the same. Is somebody hearing me? God wants you to move to greater achievement, greater favor, greater blessing, greater increase, succeeding on every side in the name of Jesus. And you know, this will occur in every area as you begin to increase your capacity, as you change your capacity, God will make you a better person. I said, God will make you a better person. Now, what is capacity? What are we talking about when we say capacity? Capacity is the ability to receive, the ability to contain. And the maximum amount or number that can be received or contained is your capacity. Look at this glass. This glass, I don't know what CL it is. Let us assume that it is 30 cl or 25 cl, 25 to 30 cl. So if it is 25 to 30 cl and I have a 75 cl bottle of water and I'm pouring it in, once I reach 30 cl, what happens to the rest? It will waste away. You see, many of us, God has 100 cl blessing, but we have a 30 cl container. God is also not a waster. Once he sees that you cannot receive all, what do you think he does with the rest? He keeps it. You know, I'm praying that you won't get to heaven and find that the store is full of your goods that you never claimed. But you see, the problem is when you get to heaven, they are useless. You can't use them anymore. So may all that belongs to you come to your hands while you are on this earth in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, I receive. Say it again, I receive. Capacity is very important. You've got to increase your capacity. And there are several things called capacity. Mental, financial, spiritual, all kinds of capacity. Some people wonder why. You've got to sit down and just look at your life and see that you've never moved beyond 1,000 in saving. Then you know that my financial capacity is still this amount. I need to do something if I want to change this capacity. Praise God. Your capacity is an indication of what you can receive, what you can hold, what you can absorb. That's your capacity. If you take this cup to the ocean, if you take it to, say, Brighton, where you see the Atlantic in front of you, if you put this cup in the Atlantic to scoop water, how much will it take? The same 30 cl. Whereas here in front of you is zillions of gallons of water. We don't know the quantity of water in the Atlantic, so we shall say zillions. Zillions of gallons of water, but you only have capacity for 30 cl. So, the provision is there, but your procurement is small because your capacity is limited. Too many. There are marriages with limited capacity, limited emotional capacity. Before you marry a man, you need to check his capacity. I'm not talking money, but even emotion. How much emotion can he give you? How much love? Because you see, love is also measured out this way. How much love can you give? So many people are unhappy in life because from start, they went for a limited capacity life. Am I making any sense? Because you are too quiet this morning. Praise God. I said praise the Lord. So if our life is going to improve 100%, oftentimes the church is even not helping us. Many times we are busy casting out, but we have not cast in anything. We've not told people, okay, we've cast out the demon. Now stretch the container so that you can take in more. Take in more. Your capacity is a measure of your ability, a measure of your performance. And you notice, we pay people according to capacity, isn't it? According to their capacity. What we pay the man who picks our garbage during the week is not what we pay our lawyer. Because each one is solving a different problem and according to capacity of the challenge. If you need a lawyer to help you sort out a major immigration matter or a major litigation that has been brought against you, it's different from the garbage man. As far as garbage is concerned, you might even carry it yourself. But you can't go to court and defend yourself unless you know all those torts and all those Latin ipso facto and so on and so forth. Is somebody hearing me this morning? Tell your neighbor to stretch. Your capacity reflects your innate potential for growth. It reflects your development. It reflects your accomplishments. It reflects it. So if you have not stretched your capacity, there's a limit to what you can handle. And this is what we're going to share in all of this morning services today. When we say capacity, we mean measure. So that glass, they already use a certain measure to let us know how much it takes. 30 cl. And you have a bottle that is 75 cl. So it means that that glass only takes 1/3 or 25% of what's in the bottle. The rest goes to waste. Capacity is resourcefulness. The thing, your ability to see different ideas. Capacity is aptitude. Your skills which God has given you. Capacity is dexterity. Being able to stand, being able to be wise, to know what to do at different times.
Wherever you are in the journey of life, you can always make that turnaround, live to the maximum, and experience a 100% life improvement. It's time to make a mark. Get this series today, available in CD, DVD, and MP3. Call now, quoting the reference number on the screen, or visit kiccshop.org.uk. 100% life improvement. Make your life a masterpiece. The Prophetic Dimension.
Everyone, stretch your hand towards these people. Begin to prophesy a divine turnaround, a change of circumstance, a healing for their body. I see some of them, they've shed too many tears recently. Come on, begin to pray for them that their tears will turn to testimony. That their tears will turn to testimony. Jesus, 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 Holy God, Holy God, Holy God, Holy God, Holy, 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 Holy God, Holy God. In Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, If anyone falls under the anointing, that's okay. Just cover them. The Holy Ghost is here. Anything can happen. Only demons are not allowed in this place tonight. God is in this place. The Holy Ghost is here. In fact, there are people receiving miracles without being called. There are people being set free without being called. God is working in somebody's life. Challenges are breaking free. God is turning your life around in the name of Jesus. If you believe it, say, I receive it. This lady here, come close. I don't know what it is, but maybe by the time I lay hands, I will know. Come close. Give me your hand. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Spirit of the living God, I pray for this woman right now. Some people stole your money. Some people took your money away. Some people have hurt you so much, particularly in the area of finance. Today, I pray for you that there will be a restoration of all that was taken from you in the mighty name of Jesus. I hear the word accusation over the things you did not do. Every false accusation, God will vindicate you and bring you out of the matter in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you today that the Holy Ghost himself will turn your life around. Will turn your life around. Mesa itulombre ishkaprindo si prelido dusa. You've lost some major things, but everything you lost, there shall be a restoration. A restoration. A restoration. There were some things you expected to work, but they did not quite work out like you expected. And you feel so disappointed, and yet you could not go back to where you are coming from, and yet you are not in the place you desire to be. But today I pray for you that the God of resurrection will give you a resurrection. He will turn your life around. He will turn your life around. So will it be. In Jesus' name, somebody give God praise for her. Come and give God praise for her. Chewa, I know you have two boys, but I keep picking issue about one of them. I don't know what it is, but one of them has issues, and a serious issue. How are your boys? Last time I saw them, they were 3 and 2. How old are now? 19 and what? 19 and 20. They were really little cheeky boys in those days. 7 feet. Okay, they were 6 and 7. Now they are 19 and 20. But one of them has issues. I keep picking it. Father, every hurt this woman have gone through, we bring healing right now. We bring healing. Spirit of the living God, heal her heart. She sowed so much into their life and they did not appreciate all that she had done. But today I bring healing and I command a turnaround. The devil does not have the final say in the life of your children. God has the final say. They will be great in the land. There will be a testimony. The Lord himself will honor your faith. He will honor your prayer. He will prove himself as a mighty God. So will it be. So will it be. Some bridges were broken and you wondered why. But God said he will never allow a bridge to stay if he was not the one who built it. So get ready for God to now work in your life. So will it be. Jesus' name. Somebody praise the Lord. Dr. Dankwa, are you also Mary? Your aunt is Mary. Okay, I was wondering. I know that Dr. Dankwa, how can you be Mary again? Praise God. Hallelujah. Hello, young lady. Yeah, I saw you in the morning. Were you in the morning? No, it wasn't you. No, it wasn't you. Okay. Give me your hand. Father, there's no health issue. Okay. Father, I pray for this young lady that you will minister to her. The hurt of childhood will not stop the greatness of the future. Favor her life. Give her a testimony. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Wherever you are in the journey of life, you can always make that turnaround, live to the maximum, and experience a 100% life improvement. It's time to make a mark. Get this series today, available in CD, DVD, and MP3. Call now, quoting the reference number on the screen, or visit kiccshop.org.uk. 100% life improvement. Make your life a masterpiece. Next time on 100% Life Improvement.
In other words, copy is the best form of flattery. Before anybody copies you, you must have been excellent. Nobody copies a bad photocopy unless a person who doesn't know the original. So be the best. Be the best. Be the best. Glory to God. So Solomon increased his capacity. Everything about him was too much. Even the pressure that comes on your life is not to destroy you. It should rather make you begin to discover other giftings and abilities you have and never knew they were there. That is the reason why we need to believe God to increase our capacity. Believe Him to make you a better person. Because listen, at the end of the day, it was God who gave Solomon that opportunity. He asked Solomon, what do you want? Solomon said, just wisdom to manage your people.
Thank you for watching with us today. We started this brand new series some weeks ago, and I would love to hear what you think. What are you doing differently? How are you improving your life? Get on the phone, send an email, or connect with me on Facebook or Twitter. This message from the book 100% Life Improvement is available now. Call the number on the screen or visit kiccshop.org for a limited period. Get a free MP3 download of a message from the series when you buy the paperback. I am sure you will be blessed. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, what a joy it is to be able to minister to these people. I pray today that your blessing rests on their life. Give them victory on every side. Show them your favor. Silence the voice of darkness, the voice of the enemy in their life. We do thank you. We say it is done. In Jesus' name. Well, make sure you get in touch with us. Remember, all the details are on the screen. Until we hear from you again and until we come your way, always remember, it's not over until you win.
Thank you for watching Winning Ways with Pastors Matthew and Yemisi Ashimolowo. We hope you've been blessed. This program has been made possible by the continued giving of our members, the KICC Air Force partners, and you, our faithful viewers. For information on how you can become a member of the KICC Air Force, call the number you see on the screen. Or email airforce@kicc.org.uk. Next time you're in town, why don't you visit us? Experience the warmth, the welcome, the worship, and the word. For location directions or ministry information, visit kicc.org.uk. Until next time, remember, it's not over until you win.